करुणालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृत वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने भूमवत्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। धातुर्ब्रह्मैव सम्प्रोक्तो जीवाख्यातमुच्यते प्रकृतिकृत्सुबन्तादेर् धातुब्रह्मात्मने नमः। नारायणः परो व्यक्ता दण्डम् अव्यक्तसम्भवं मण्डस्यान्तस्तु मे लोकाः सप्तद्वीपा च मेति। I think we finished the 10th verse. We said, Nad Bhishta Kuchalam Karma, Kuchale Nanushajyate, Tyagi Sattva Samavishtaha Medhavi Chinna Samshayaha. So the Karma Yogi, taking to the path towards Jnana Yoga for Moksha, does not hate any karma, does not have Dvesha towards any karma, and does not associate with any karma. Something where there is raga, raga vishaya karma, such karma he does not associate himself with, does not get attached to. So associate in the sense, he associates as a karta, but without any phalakangsha or raga towards the action itself, karma itself. And he does not have dvesha towards kamya karma ityadi, although he has given it up. That kind of a tyagi, sattva samavishta, being sattva guna yukta, and medhavi, because the same nitya naimittika karma done with the attitude of karma yoga makes him medhavi by providing chitta shuddhi, and jnana starts functioning, thereby over a period of time he'll be chinna samshaya. In the literal sense, currently it means he has no doubts about which is the marga to moksha. So chinna samshaya is atma swarupa avasthanam eva param nishresa sadhanam na anyat kinchid sadhanam asti iti evam nischayena chinna samshaya. He has nischaya regarding the jnana leading to moksha, and nishtha in atma itself being moksha, nothing else being needed after that. Saha adhikrata purusha purvoktena prakarana karma yoga anushthanena kramena samskruta atma san. So this adhikari in the sense one who has adhikara in karma, a karma yogi here, that kind of a sadhaka purvoktena prakarena. So there is a question about what is the methodology, what is the krama. That krama has been mentioned now, purvoktena prakarena karma yoga anushthanena, following karma yoga kramena, in time, through the sequence of karma yoga and then chitta shuddhi, shravana working, manana, and then nididhyasana. That is a krama, but karma yoga anushthana initially, as a first step, what will it give? Atma samskara, meaning antakkarana samskara, chitta shuddhi. Thereby the person becomes samskruta atma. Atma is antakkarana here. So samskrutam antakkaranam yasya. Samskrutaha atma antakkaranam yasya saha samskruta atma. And being that kind of a person, samskruta atma asan, janmadi vikriya rahitatvena nishkriyam, has no other kriya left once janmadi vikriya is seen to be belonging to the sharira, shariratraya, not the atma. Thereby nishkriyam atmanam atmatvena sambuddha, knowing that atma, which is bereft of kriya. Oh, I think we saw this ending part of the 10th. So sarvakarmani manasa saha sarvakarmani manasa sanyasya naiva kurvanna karyan asina Naishkarmi Lakshanam Jnana Nishtham Ashnute Chetat. So he attains Jnana Nishtha, which is characterized by Nishkarma, having no karma, and thereby does not, becoming a sannyasi, does not make anyone do, and he doesn't do. So na kurvan na karyan, without doing any karma and not making others do, not prodding others to do. Jnana nishtham ashnute ityeta purvoktasya karma yogasya prayojanam aneneva shlokena uktam. What is the prayojana? Chitta shuddhi and nishchaya about jnana leading to moksha. That is the krama. And once one knows that jnana nishtha itself is moksha, atma nishtha is a moksha, then one commits to jnana. Mumukshu becomes jnyasu with purushartha nishchaya and also with the sadhana nishchaya. Yaha puna adhikrita san dehatma vimanatvena dehabhrut. So one who is dehabhrut, yaha puna has been said. So in contrast to this karma yogi who is wanting to become a jnani, in contrast to this kind of a karma yogi, the karmi, yaha puna adhikritah san, who has adhikara in karma but not a karma yogi, he is considering himself as a jiva. So jiva pranadharane, thereby dehabhrut, deham vibharti iti dehabhrut, he considers himself as deha vimani. I have this deha, I have this deha makes me a particular entity, a transmigrating jiva. This is the understanding of an ajna. So dehatma deha atma abhimanitvena, deha eva atma iti abhimanah yasya. So he has an abhimana that deha atma, thereby dehatma abhimanitvena dehabhrut. Ajnaha, an ajnani, abhadita atma kartrutva vijnanataya ahankarta iti nishchita buddhihi. And he has a nishchita buddhi. He has ascertained that I am the karta, ahankarta. Why? Because there is no kartrutva vijnana which is countered by jnana. So jnana isn't there, therefore abhadita atma kartrutva vijnanataya. Due to having vijnana of kartrutva, this is a vijnana which is needed for a karmi to act. In Purva Mimamsa, in the Karma Kanda, one has to be an adhikari by knowing oneself as a karta. Then he searches for the karana to reach the goal, to reach the sadhya vishaya. Therefore, his kartrutva vijnana should not be countered then when he is a karma yogi. When he is a karmi, not a karma yogi, karmi. So, abhadita atma kartrutva vijnanataya. He thinks that I am a karta, atma is me. First person, abhadita atma kartrutva vijnanataya aham karta. Therefore, he has concluded that I am the karta, iti nishchita buddhi. Iti nishchita buddhi yasya sa nishchita buddhi ajnaha tasya ashesha karma parityagasya ashakyatvat. Since this ajna, being a karta who wants to do karma, who thinks himself as a deha, or at least associated with the deha in some manner, has abhimana there, therefore it is impossible for him to give up the karma completely. Ashesha karma parityagasya ashakyatvat tasya karma phalatyagena chodita karma anushthane eva adhikaraha. So what is his adhikara in? He is an adhikari, adhikrita san. What kind of adhikara does he have? He has adhikara in karma anushthana, in performing karma. What kind of karma? Chodita karma, prescribed for his varanashrama. So karma phalatyagena, but this karmi has an adhikara in karma also and in karma phala tyaga also. If he holds on to karma phala, then he becomes a karmi. But since he wants to do tyaga finally, he wants to do tyaga, ashesha karma parityaga is right now ashakya for him. So what is the means? He has adhikara in the chodita karma, and then he has, basically he has eligibility to do nitya naimittika karma, but he can give up phala. So karma phala tyage na chodita karma anushthane eva adhikara na tatyage. He has karma phala tyaga adhikara, but not karma tyaga adhikara. Sarva karma tyaga is impossible, and karma tyaga he has no adhikara in. If he gives up that karma, that kind of tyaga will either become tamasika tyaga or rajasika tyaga. It won't be satvika tyaga. Na tatyage iti etamartham darshayitum ah. He has no adhikara in tyaga. Therefore, the next verse is taught by Bhagavan Krishna as Nahi deha bhrata shakyam tyaktum karmani sheshatah yastu karma phalatyagi satyagi ityabhidhiyate. Therefore, there is a praise here that one who is a karma phalatyagi, he is a tyagi, he is called as a tyagi. It is stuti, as Bhagavan Bhashyakara says, stutyartham. Nahi na hi deha bhrata shakyam tyaktum karmani asheshatah yaha tu karma phalatyagi saha tyagi iti abhidiyate. Said to be a tyagi. Who is that? Yaha karma phalatyagi. In contrast to what? Deha bhrita karmani asheshatah tyaktum na shakyam. Nahi shakyam. He is yasmat. Yasmat karanat. And tu is therefore in contrast. Deha, by a deha bhrata is tritiya ekvachana. Deha bhrata karmani asheshatah tyaktum nahi shakyam. It is impossible for one who is embodied to give up the karma completely, give up all the karmas completely, asheshatah. Therefore what? Therefore, who is a tyagi? Dehabhrut cannot be a tyagi because he cannot give up the karma completely. So who can give up is a tyagi. Now who can give up is a tyagi? He is not even in the context, because who can give up has given up. So there is someone in between, a karma yogi. His stuti is being done by saying yaha tu karma phala tyagi sah tyagi iti abhidiyate stutyartham. He has done tyaga of karma phala. So since he cannot give up karma, he has no adhikara in sannyasa. He has adhikara in karma. But what else does he have adhikara in? He has adhikara in giving up the karma phala also. So if he chooses that option of giving up karma phala, then he will not be a karmi, he will be a tyagi. That was the comparison we saw in the last part of how satvika tyaga contrast with the Rajas and Tamasa Tyaga. Thereby, this person who has no adhikara in sannyasa is praised to be a sannyasi tyagi because he gives up karma phala due to being a karma yogi. Nahi, he is yasmat. Nahi, yasmat deha bhruta. Who is deha bhrut? Tritiya ekvachana. So deha bhrut is deham vivarti iti deha bhrut. One who holds and supports the body by being there. Jiva pranadharane dehatma abhimanavan. So final meaning is dehatma abhimanavan. Who has abhimana in deha, he is called as dehavrut. Dehavrut uchyate na viveki. He is not a viveki who can discriminate between atma and anatma. For that jnana viveka to take place, whereby vairagya will be complete, lead to Shamadamadi, Shatka Sampatti, and then Mumukshu. He'll become Mumukshu by gaining Mumukshuttvam in totality. Till then, he has to walk the path of कर्मयोग सही वेदा विनाशिनम नित्यम सही वेदा विनाशिनम नित्यम येनम अजम अव्ययम कथम स पुरुष पार्थ कंघातयति हंतिकम। सो दिस देहभृत इज नॉट अ विवेकी सही वेदा विनाशिनम इत्यादिना कर्तृत्वाधिकारात् निवर्तितः। In this verse, in the second chapter, 21st verse, Veda Vinashinam Nityam, Ya Enam Ajam Avyayam Veda, Yaha Enam Atmanam Avinashinam, Avinashinam Atmanam Nityam Ajam Avyayam Veda, Saha Purushaha He Partha Kam Ghatayati Kam Hanti, and also katham ghatayati katham hanti. We saw this in the last part also. So that kind of a person who knows atmanam vijanati as what kam hanti kam ghatayati, meaning akarta atma, who knows this atma as akarta, aja, avyaya, avinashi, that is a viveki. But this Dehabhruti is not a Viveki. He does not know that. He does not have Atmajnana. He does not know details. Ityadina kartrutva adhikarat nivartitaha. So the Jnani has no adhikara in the karma, because kam ghateti kam hanti is a prathamalla nyaya whereby all karmas have been denied. So Viveki, Jnani, does not have adhikara in karma at all. So who has adhikara in karma? Only Dehabhrut, who considers himself as karta. Ataha tena Dehabhruta ajnena na shakyam tyaktum sanyasitum karmani asheshata nisheshena. Therefore, by this Dehabhrut, who is an ajna, it is impossible to give up the karma completely. Sanyasitum na shakyam. Asheshata is nisheshena. Completely. Tasmat yahatu ajnyaha. Therefore, one who is ajnya, he alone has adhikara in karma. Adhikrita nityani karmani kuruvan. Karma phalatyagi, karma phalavisandhi matra sanyasi satyagiti abhidhiyate. So, therefore, this adhikari in karma, who has no adhikara in sannyasa, who cannot give up karma completely, he can become a karma yogi, which will pave the path towards sannyasa, real sannyasa. Sarva karma sannyasa, through jnana. So, towards jnana, he needs a path paved through chitta shuddhi, for which the means is karma yoga, which is by giving up karma phala while doing karma. You cannot give up karma phala without doing karma. Karma tyaga is not karma phala tyaga. Karma phala tyaga while doing karma is karma yoga. Therefore, tasmat yastu ajnyaha adhikrita nityani karmani kuruvan, doing the nitya karmas and giving up karma phala, therefore karma phala tyagi, meaning karma phalavisandhi matra sannyasi. He is a sannyasi. What kind of sannyasi? Karma phala abhisandhi matra sannyasi. He has karma phala abhi matra sannyasa. He has that kind of tyaga whereby he gives up only the association with karma phala. This matra tells you that he is not a real sannyasi. In the true sense of the word, satyagi iti abhidiyate, he is stutyartham, for the purpose of praise of karma yoga in contrast to karma or kevala sannyasa. This kevala sannyasa word has come up earlier in the second and third chapters. Kevala sannyasa is not good to take. One should not take kevala sannyasa. It will fall into tamasa or rajasika variety, rajasa variety, it will not be sattvika sannyasa. It won't be sannyasa for the right purpose also. It will also be sannyasa without having adhikara in sannyasa. Thereby, sahatyagi iti abhidiyate, the karma yogi is praised as tyagi. Karmi api san iti stutya viprayena. Why is he called as tyagi or sannyasi? Because stuti is in contrast with the other two types of sannyasas, not sattvika sannyasa. Therefore, although he is a karmi, he is praised as a tyagi. Tasmat paramartha darshina eva adeha bhruta dehatma bhava rahitena ashesha karma sannyasa shakyate kartum. Who can take sannyasa of the type where no karma is being done? Who can give up karma completely? Paramartha darshi alone. So only by paramartha darshi, paramartha darshina eva, who is adeha bhrut, not deha bhrut, adeha bhruta eva dehatma bhava rahitena. Adeha bhrut means what? He has no dehatma bhava. Then he has lost adhikara in karma at all. Karma can be done only with deha. Stula and sukshma both. Stula deha is the ayatana. Bhoga ayatana also for karma you need to be in a sharira. So you need to be in the deha. And then sukshma sharira is bhoga sadhana. Also karma sadhana, it will help you do karma. Therefore, adeha bhruta paramartha darshina eva dehatma bhava rahitena adeha bhruta ashesha karma sannyasa kartum shakyate. So ashesha karma sannyasa shakyate kartum means one, that kind of a sannyasi, that kind of a jnani alone has eligibility in sarvakarma sannyasa. Who is adeha bhrut? Kim punah tat prayojanam yat sarvakarma sannyasat syaditi uchyate. So if the question is, what is that prayojana? What would one get if one takes sarvakarma sannyasa? One becomes a paramartha darshi, meaning anishtamishtam mishrancha trividham karmanah phalam bhavatyatyaginam prityatya natu sannyasinam kvachit. So anishtam, ishtam, mishram cha trividham karmanah phalam bhavati atyaginam prityatya natu sannyasinam kvachit. So prayojanam kim? What is that prayojana? That prayojana is trividham phalam na bhavati. So one will not get trivida phala. What is this trivida phala? Anishta, ishta and mishra. What one does not want, meaning papakrita, those kind of shariras, adogati. Ishta is what? Punyakrita shariras, lokas, devata sharira ityadi. Mishram is manushya sharira, where punya and papa are approximately 50-50. Those are the karma phala of three types. Atyaginam bhavati, for those who are not tyagis, pretya, having died, atyaginam trividham karmana phalam bhavati. So you can say anishtam ishtam mishrancha trividham karmana phalam atyaginam pretya bhavati. Natu sannyasinam kvachit trividham phalam bhavati. Meaning kvachidapi trividham phalam sannyasinam na bhavati. That is the anvaya there. What is anishta? Naraka tiryagadi lakshanam. So adogati in an animal body or a plant body, tree body, and naraka, naraka vasa, all these are anishta phala. Ishtam is devadi lakshana, characterized by ishtam devadi lakshanam. Mishram, ishtanishta sanyuktam manushya lakshanam cha. And what is mishra? Mixed, ishta anishta sanyukta. So punya and papa are mixed. There is not a lot of papa to get naraka, tiryagadi, janma, narakavasa or tiryagadi janma, prani janma, or devadi lakshana janma, pitriloka, deva, deva, swargaloka ityadi. Those are possible only if punya is in great measure. Meaning punya and papa is always in a huge measure as a backlog in Sanchita. Because anadi janma, all sorts of karmas have been done by all jivas. There is nothing new that a jiva will be doing in karma. It is cyclical. One keeps on doing all sorts of karmas. Some good, some bad. So there is nothing that one has never done. Even when we point out something good in someone, I would like to do that, we have done that. When you look at someone who is doing karma which is horrible, I would never in my worst dreams think of doing such karma. We can assume that we have done that also. Because anadi kala, anadi janma, and anadi itself tells you that all sorts of karmas we have done except for taking to jnana. Everything has been done. That should be vairagya karaka. So we have got naraka tiryagadi lakshana janma also. We have got devadi lakshana janma also. Phala. And we got mishra also. Next up, ishta anishta sanyukta manushya lakshana. Over and over again. Tatra trividham triprakaram karmanaha dharmadharma lakshanasya phalam bahya aneka karaka vyapara nishpannam sat avidyakrutam indrajala mayopamam mahamohakaram pratyag atmopasarpi iha phalgutaya layam adarshanam gachyatiti phala nirvachanam tad etat evan lakshanam phalam bhavati atyaginam ajnanam karminam aparmartha sanyasinam pretya sharira patat urdhvam. So long sentence. Tatra trividham. Trividham is triprakaram. Karmana phalam. The karma phala is of three types. Triprakara. Dharma dharma lakshanasya phalam. So karmana phalam is what? What is karma? Dharma dharma lakshana karma. Karma which is either dharma or adharma. Neutral does not necessarily have a particular karma phala. If it is there anyway, we don't care much for it. You know, you say, you know, doing something interesting, not doing something interesting, or something, you know, time pass activity. Nothing really happening. Life just ticking. That is what neutral karma is. Somehow surviving. In the general course of language. In karma, what the Shruti prescribes to be done, or that which will bring you punya, that is dharma lakshana phala, that will give you dharma lakshana phala. And what is adharma is papa. So nishiddha karma will give you adharma lakshana phala. Neuter is Shruti neither does nisheda nor does it say you do it. If you do it, there is no issue. So some karmas, many karmas fall in neuter also. There is no punya or papa from that karma. It will leave some vasanas and does not really bring good or bad. Bahya aneka karaka vyapara nishpannam sat. So it is, this phala is attained through what? Aneka karaka vyapara nishpannam. Bahya. All these are through the bahya aneka karakas. Such kind of vyapara brings in this phala. Therefore, bahya aneka karaka vyapara nishpannam sat phalam avidya krutam. It is all avidya karya. Avidya kama karma. That is the chain. Avidya is there. As long as avidya is there, kama will manifest as ragadvesha, will make a person do or avoid something, and thereby to avoid also do something else. Therefore, karma. Avidya jala maya upamam, which is comparable, this avidya krita karma is what? Comparable to Indrajala maya. comparable to magic. Mahamohakaram, and it deludes. The more you keep on doing, the more is the work binding. The more it will entangle. The more difficult it will get to come out of it. The more difficult it will be for jnana to set in. The more difficult it will be to accept jnana. One will keep on getting dragged down. It is like quicksand. You can't be in the quicksand and assume that you will be pulled out. So, Mahamohakaram, not simply Mohakaram, Mahamohakaram. The more you get deep into a quicksand, the more difficult it is to come out. So, Pratyagatmopasarpi. So, Upasarpin. Upasarpin is one who is attaining. So, one who is attaining that. Approaching or attaining Pratyagatma. So, Mahamohakaram Pratyagatmopasarpi. So, Avidyakruta Phala Indrajala Mayopavam Mahamohakaram Pratyagatmopasarpi Iha Phalagutaya Layam Gachati. Phalagutaya is, Phalagu is something unsubstantial, having no, no content really. So that is phala. The phala is explained here. Phalgutaya layam gacchati iti phalam. Phala nirvachanam means it is the explanation for phala. What is phala? Phalgutaya layam gacchati. Laya is adarshanam. So this Pratyagatmopasarpi iha, one who is approaching the Atmajnana, wanting to be a mumukshu, for him also it is moha, Mahamohakara, this avidya krita phala. Avidya krita phala, which is, and what is phala? Phalgutaya layam gacchati. Like something unsubstantial, it will not last for long. The phala perishes. In time, you keep any fruit, it is going to perish. Therefore, it is called as phalam. It is a meaningful word. The utpatti is meaningful. Phalgutaya layam gacchati iti phalam. Any fruit perishes. So, this result is called as phala. Karma phala. Why is it called as phala? The result of karma is called as phala because like a fruit, it will perish. How much ever you try to preserve a fruit, it will perish. Phalgutaya layam adarshanam gacchati iti phala nirvachanam. Tad etad evam lakshanam phalam. This kind of a phala is what everyone wants. Everyone is struggling for that phala, which by definition itself, phalgutaya layam gacchati. Without knowing that we are craving for a result which is going to perish, still we crave for that phala. So, etad taretad evam lakshanam phalam bhavati atyaginam. For atyagis, ajnyas, karmis alone that phala can accrue, which will never last, will perish away, will wither away in time, not for sannyasi. So, atyaginam phalam bhavati. Who are atyagis? Ajnyas. Therefore, ajnyanam karminam, those who are karmi. Further what? Aparamartha sannyasinam. Those kind of tyagis who are not paramartha tyagi. So, not a paramartha sannyasi. They don't have jnana. So, for whatever reason, whatever kind of sannyasas you consider, they are doing karma and calling themselves sannyasis, or they have taken sannyasa without having any inclination towards jnana, tesham bhavati phalam, when pretya, means sharira patat urdhvam, after the drop of the body, they'll get the phala, which will not last for long, whether it is good or bad, पुण्य और पाप रूप फल धर्म अधर्म लक्षण फल इट विल बी देयर ओनली फॉर अत्यागीस न तो सन्यासी नाम नॉट फॉर सन्यासी विच काइंड ऑफ सन्यासी सन्यासी इन द ट्रू सेंस ऑफ द वर्ड हु हैज ज्ञान ज्ञानकृत सन्यास नॉट सन्यास मीनिंग जस्ट प्लेन सन्यास विदाउट नॉट आश्रम सन्यास विदाउट ज्ञान सो सन्यास विद ज्ञान देयरफॉर न तो सन्यासी नाम मीन्स परमार्थ सन्यासी नाम परमहंस परिव्राजका नाम केवल ज्ञान निष्ठा नाम क्वचित नॉट फॉर केवल सन्यासी बट सन्यासी विद परमार्थ सन्यासी देयरफॉर परमहंस परिव्राजक सन्यासी हु हैज द हाईएस्ट टाइप ऑफ सन्यास विच इज विद ज्ञान विद्वत सन्यास विच विल लीड टू निष्ठा देयरफॉर विच वन हु हैज निष्ठा इन ज्ञान आत्मस्वरूप लक्षण निष्ठा विच वॉज टॉक्ड अबाउट इन टेंथ वर्स दैट वी क्लोज्ड केवल ज्ञान निष्ठा नाम न भवति क्वचित न भवति नो वेर इन नो वे दैट्स द आइडिया देयर केवल ज्ञान निष्ठा नाम फलम न भवति दे विल नॉट गेट कर्म फल बिकॉज दे हैव गिवन अप कर्म कंप्लीटली अशेष कर्म संन्यासी नहीं केवल सम्यक दर्शन निष्ठा अविद्यादि संसार बीजम न उन्मूलयति कदाचित इत्यर्थः सो न डबल निगेशन हैज बीन यूज्ड न एंड न अगेन न उन्मूलयति कदाचित केवल सम्यक दर्शन निष्ठा अविद्यादि संसार बीजम न न सो डबल निगेशन मीन्स उन्मूलयति कदाचित इत्यर्थ केवल सम्यक दर्शन निष्ठा सो केवल सम्यक दर्शन निष्ठा दैट इज ऑल दैट इज नीडेड टू टेक अवे अविद्यादि संसार बीज नथिंग एल्स इज नीडेड इट अप्रूट्स इट कंप्लीटली देयर बाय नो फला कैन एक्रू संचित आगामी बोथ आर डिस्ट्रॉयड एंड आफ्टर द फॉल ऑफ द बॉडी प्रेत्य शरीर पाता दूर्ध्वम इवन दि प्रारब्ध इज गॉन अतः परमार्थदर्शिन एव अशेषकर्म संन्यासित्वं संभवति सो फॉर हूम इज दि अशेषकर्म संन्यास पॉसिबल फॉर अ परमार्थदर्शी अलोन वन हूम हैज दि राइट विजन ऑफ परमात्मा एज मी अहम ब्रह्मास्मि दैट काइंड ऑफ नॉलेज लीड्स टू अशेषकर्म संन्यास नॉट अदरवाइज अविद्याध्यारोपितत्वात् आत्मनि क्रियाकारक फलानाम् सो अशेष कर्म संन्यासित्वम् अविद्याध्यारोपितत्वात् आत्मनि क्रियाकारक फलानाम् अशेष कर्म संन्यासित्वम् संन्यास इज ऑफ व्हाट संन्यास इज ऑफ क्रियाकारक एंड फल विच आर सुपरइम्पोज ऑन आत्मा व्हाई ड्यू टू अविद्या अध्यारोप सो अविद्या अध्यारोपितत्वात् आत्मनि क्रियाकारक फलानाम एंड वी कैन ब्रिंग इन दिस अशेष कर्म संन्यासित्वम टू अंडरस्टैंड संन्यास ऑफ दीज अशेष क्रियाकारक फल ऑल विच आर सुपर इम्पोज ऑन आत्मा व्हाट डू यू नीड टू टेक संन्यास फ्रॉम दीज दे आर सुपर इम्पोज ज्ञान संन्यास संभवती अशेष कर्म संन्यास न तो अज्ञस्य इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल फॉर एन अज्ञ बिकॉज देर इज नो पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ आत्मज्ञान देर ही डज नॉट अंडरस्टैंड दैट क्रियाकारक फलाज आर अविद्या अध्यारोपित ऑन आत्मा न तो अज्ञस्य अधिष्ठानादीनि क्रियाकर्तृक क्रियाकर्तृकारकाणि आत्मत्वेनैव पश्यतः अशेषकर्मसन्न्यास संभवति तदेतद् उत्तरे श्लोकैः दर्शयति भगवान् दर्शयति भगवान् टीचेस थ्रू दि उत्तर श्लोकास फॉलोइंग श्लोकास दैट आइडिया विच इज व्हाट अशेषकर्मसन्न्यास न संभवति कस्य अज्ञस्य फॉर एन अज्ञ अशेषकर्मसन्न्यास इज नॉट पॉसिबल Why? Because he is Pashyan. He is one who is seeing. Seeing what? Kriya Kartru Karakani Atmatvena. Eva. he is seeing oneself as associated with kriya karta and karaka. He has abhimana in kriya by being a karta using karaka for a particular bhoga phala in mind, which are adhishthanadini. All the karakas, adhishthanadini, kriya, kartru, karakani. All the karaka bhedas are encouraged for a karmi. Without that, karma is not possible. One has to bare minimum consider oneself as karma, see the other karakas, and then do the karma. Therefore, karta, karma, karana, adhikarana, bare minimum are needed. Therefore, ashesha karma sannyasa tasya ajnyasya na sambhavati. Iti etat. This kind of an idea, tadetat, uttaraihi shlokaihi bhagavan darshayati. What are those? Panchaitani mahabaho karanani nibodhame sankhye kritante proktani siddhaye sarva karmanam. So, pancha etani he mahabaho karanani nibodha me vachanat mama vachanat nibodha sankhye kritante proktani siddhaye sarva karmanam. So pancha etani he mahabaho etani pancha me vachanat nibodha. What are those karanani? So pancha etani karanani he mahabaho pancha etani karanani me nibodha, me vachanat nibodha. May you know completely, doubtlessly, nibodha. Karanani, what are the karanas? Five, pancha. These are the five karanas, O Mahabahu, Arjuna. May you know from my words, says Bhagavan. Sankhye kritante. Sankhya. Sankhya we have seen in the second chapter. Jnana. Krita anta. So, kritaha antaha yasmin sankhye tat sankhyam kritantam. What is sankhyam? Sankhyam is that in which anta is nishchaya. So, in that jnana, sankhye jnane, kritam antaha nishchayaha, meaning Vedanta, the anta of what? Anta of karma also. So Bhagavan Bhashyakara will explain this in both ways. He'll use this in both ways, not at the same place. Krita anta, krita is what? All is proktani. Sarva karmanam siddhaye. Siddhaye is chaturthi, tadarthi chaturthi. Sarva karmanam siddhaye, to accomplish all actions. How do you accomplish all actions? Only a krita kritya can say that I have done everything. Who is a krita kritya? Jnani. But that is a siddhi. How do you get that siddhi? Jnanena. So, sarva karmanam siddhaye, proktani, all that has been mentioned, proktani, sankhye kritante. So, in jnana, parisamyapyate ityartha. All these find their end in jnana. And this idea has come up in the second and the third chapter also. We'll see that. In the fourth chapter, second chapter and fourth chapter also, it has come. Topic. Sarvam karma akhilam partha jnane parisamapyate yava arthodapane sarvatas samplutodake tavan artha. So, we've seen this sloka. So, tavan artha. Brahmanasya vijanata, tavan artha, we'll see that anyway. So anyway, let's seem to have lost one word there. So vedeshu ya. So yavan artha udapane sarvata sampluto udake tavan sarveshu vedeshu brahmanasya vijanataha sarveshu vedeshu. We'll come back to this. This idea has been mentioned. So, jnane parisamapyate in sankhya. So, instead of jnana, here it is sankhye. Parisam, kritante sankhye. in that kind of sankhya, sarva karmanam siddhaye proktani, all these have been mentioned. Finally, for what purpose? Sarva karmanam siddhaye proktani etani pancha. He mahabaho pancha etani me vachanat nibodha. What are those karanani? Pancha etani karanani. They are proktani. Why? Sarva karmanam siddhaye sankhye krutante proktani. So they are all as though as well attained. All those are mentioned for the sarva karma siddhi, ending up in sankhya, culminating in sankhya. Pancha etani vakshamanani, these are going to be talked about. Which are these five? Will be talked about. These are the karanas. There are five karanas. Nirvartakani, he mahabhav, karanani is nirvartakani, those which are accomplishing factors, those which will help you accomplish something. What? Basically sarva karma. All karmas, you need five factors. Nibodha me mama vachanat iti uttaratra cheta samadhanartham vastu vaishamya pradarshanartham cha. So this, he says nibodha me, meaning it is going to come up. Why? For cheta samadhana. So manas samadhana, it is going to come up. And vastu vaishamya. So you, what are these five? So he says that you understand from my vachanas. And he'll so vastu vaishamya pradarshanartham, means he's going to show how these differ. Tani cha karanani jnatavyataya stauti. And then he says these karanas, there is a praise done of these karanas. Proktani, they are mentioned. How are they praised? Jnatavyataya, that they should be known. Only if you know, they will, you know, help you reach the goal of sankhya. So sankhye jnatavyaha padarthaha sankhyante sankhyayante. So sankhye, sankhya is defined now. What is sankhya vitpatti? Sankhyayante yasmin shastre tat sankhyam vedantaha. So sankhya is vedanta, not sankhya darshana. Sankhya is the second chapter of sankhya, jnana yoga, that is called as vedanta. Jnatavyaha padartha, these padarthas should be known. Sankhyayanti means they are counted. These five are counted. Yasmin shastra, in whichever shastra, that shastra is called as sankhya. So why is called that sankhya? Because these factors are counted. Pradarthas are counted in Vedanta. That shastra is called as sankhya. Krutante iti tasya visheshanam. So krutante sankhye. Saptami ekvachana. Krutante. It is a visheshana for sankhya. And what is Kritanta? Can understand as Vedanta also. But Bhagavan Bhashyakara says, what kind of Vedanta is this? Sankhya. It is Kritanta, meaning Kritam iti karma uchyate. He says Krita is karma. How so? Once you reach to Vedanta, the culmination of Vedas is Vedanta. Earlier, Karma Kanda also culminates in Vedanta. Uttara Kanda, Jnana Kanda. How? Jnane parismapyate. Once you come to jnana, all karma drops off. Why? Krita krityo bhavati. One becomes krita kritya. Therefore, you can call it as Vedanta, Kritanta, and krita is karma there. So, kritam iti karma uchyate. Tasya antaha, kritasya antaha, karmana antaha, parisamapti, nishchaya parisamapti, nishchayena parisamapti. Culminates there. Yatra yasmin saha kritantaha, meaning karmantaha. Because Krita is karma, you can call it as Karmantaha, which is actually Vedanta, because Vedanta is Sankhya and Kritanta is a visheshan of Vedanta. So Kritanta Vedanta, Karmanta Vedanta. Kritanta Sankhya means Karmanta Vedanta. Iti etatu, that is the idea. Because all karma will finally culminate in jnana once you know that karma is not going to give me nitya phala. Phala by definition is what? Is phalgutaya liyate iti phalam. So there will be laya. So Nitya and Phala itself is contradictory. You cannot have Nitya Phala. Phala will always be Anitya by very definition also in Vyakarana Shastra. So result of any karma is called as Phala because it is Anitya. So how can you say Nitya Phala? Nitya Phala itself is an impossible combination. It is an oxymoron. You cannot have Nitya Phala. If it is Nitya, it cannot be Phala. If it is Phala, it has to be Anitya. So Parisamapti of karma will not be in karma phala, it will be in jnana. Yavanarthodapane. So then he quotes that. Yavanarthodapane sarvatasampludodake tavan sarveshu vedeshu brahmanasya vijanataha. Whatever meaning is there, the example is the water. Whatever udapane in any water, whatever artha, artha is purpose there, prayojanam. Whatever prayojana is there in any water, that prayojana is attained if you don't go hunting for a well or lake, if there is flood. There is flood in the sense, everywhere there is water, sarvata sampludodake. If the water rises, then there is water all around. So you don't have to look for a particular well. No, I need only that well. That well has flooded outside. Due to rains everywhere, there is water everywhere. Of course, I mean, cleanliness, all this is assumed there. What I said is that you don't have to look for water if water is everywhere. Similarly, so you don't have to say that I need only little water. So if you are searching for little water, the idea is what? If you have a lot of water everywhere, then that little water that you are searching for in one place and another, all those are served by the water being available everywhere by flood. Tavan sarveshu vedeshu brahmanasya vijanata. Tavan, so tavan will go with the example and the exemplified yavan also. So yavan arthah udapane bhavati tavan sarvata samplutodake api bhavati tavan eva arthah. That prayojana is met even by flooded water. In lot of water, small water bodies are included. Similarly, yavan sarveshu vedeshu arthah tavan vijanatah brahmanasya artha api. So vijanata, vijanan is who? Vijanan is one who has jnana, vishesha jnana. Vishesha jnana in the sense he has aikya jnana. That kind of brahmana, brahma janati iti brahmana, tasya brahmanasya, vijanata brahmanasya, aham brahmasmi iti vijanata brahmanasya, sarveshu vedeshu yavan arthaha tavaneva bhavati arthaha. So he will have the same purpose met as whatever is met by sarveshu vedeshu, means in all karmas discussed in the Vedas, all upasanas, all phalas are attained because all are finally tuned towards sukha. That sukha he gets here in ananda swarupa atma. Thereby he is kritakritya. He does not need any phala, which is anitya. Even if he does all the karmas, he still won't get nitya phala. He would get nitya phala, and in nitya phala, all the anityas are included. As though, that is the idea here. And another quotation given, sarvam karma akhilam partha jnane parisamapyate. So in the jnana, there is a culmination of all, sarvam. So Shriyan dravyamayad yajna jnana yajna parantapa sarvam karma akhilam partha jnane parisamapyate. So the focus is on the second part. He parantapa, Arjuna, Shriyan dravyamayad yajnyat. So dravyamayad yajnyat jnana yajna shriyan. Jnana yajna is superior to what? Dravyamayad yajnyat. It is superior to dravyamaya yajna. Yajna, when not qualified, just a statement of yajna means dravyamaya yajna, where dravyas are included, dravyas are offered to the devatas, invoking the Agni Devata. Other devatas are also invoked, and then to them dravyas are offered through Agni. That is the dravyamaya yajna. Compared to such dravyamaya yajna, jnana yajna, yajna iva yajna, jnana yajna is shreyan, it is superior. Why so? Jnane he partha sarvam akhilam karma parisamapyate. This is a hetu for the first half. Because in jnana, all the karma, entire karma, all the karmas culminate. So this has come up in 2nd and 4th chapter. In 18th chapter, it is summed up by saying, Panchayetani ityadi sarvakarmanam siddhaye. Iti atmajnane sanjate sarvakarmanam nivrittin darshayati. One becomes kritakritya and then does not need to do any karma once there is jnanodaya. What kind of jnana? Atmajnana. Ataha tasmin atmajnanarthe sankhye kritante vedante proktani kathitani siddhaye nishpatyartham sarvakarmanam. So sarvakarmanam siddhaye, meaning nishpatyarthe, nishpatyartham. To attain all karmas, how do you attain the phala of all karmas? By attaining the nitya, all the anitya phala is included. And that is the reason all these are proktani, karanani. These five will lead to, understanding of these five will lead to karanas. In each and every karma, there are five factors involved. If you understand them, then it will lead to jnana. Which kind of jnana? That jnana where every karma, all karmas culminate. Therefore, Sankhye, Kritante, Vedante, in that Vedanta where nothing else needs to be done, Atmajnanarthe, Proktani, Kathitani, these are mentioned. What are those? Kanitani, Iti Uchyate. What are those? Proktani, Karanani, Pancha, Etani, what are those? Adishthanam tatha adishthanam tatha karta karanam cha prathagvidam vividash cha prathakcheshta daivam chaivatra panchamam. Adishthanam tatha karta. Adishthana is one, karta is second, karanam third, karanam cha prathagvidam. Way of various types. Adishthana, karta, karana. These are the three. Vividash cha prathakcheshtaha. There are various kriyas, karma. So fourth. What is the fifth? Daivam cha evatra panchamam. Daivam is panchamam. So you have to understand daivam. Karta you are. Karana is available. Adishthana is there. Cheshtas are there. All karma kriyas are there. So karta, vividaha pratak cheshta, meaning karma, various types of karma, various types of karana. Karta is there, adishthana is there. Still, without the fifth, nothing will happen. Daiva is necessary ingredient, a necessary factor. This makes or breaks all this. So, daivam. Daivam is what? Some deva sambandhi. There is Ishvara manifesting as a deva, adishtatra devata, who will be a be an essential part of all this. So in each and every sarvakarmanam siddhaye, what is needed really? These five are needed. Daiva, panchama is definitely needed. This daiva is missed. Now I am a karta, I will do whatever I need, whatever it takes to get to the result. This is the thinking. I have resources, I have karana. Adishtana I can get. Wherever I want to perform, I will get that desha. Then, being a karta, with all my karana resources, prathagvidam, whatever is needed, I can get. Then, vividaha cha prathakcheshtaha. There are so many activities to be done. I will do all of them. But daiva, you have no control over it. In fact, daiva will drive the karana make the karta also capable enough. Various types of prithak vidha karanas, whether they are available or not, they are also due to daiva. That will decide. So daiva has a lot of meaning, but here it is the Ishvara manifesting as adhishtatru devata, moving the indriyas, karanas, all these. And then all these prithak cheshta also governed by a lot of factors based on the niyati, Ishvara niyati. So it's a short one. I'll just finish this so we get an end to one verse. Adhishthanam Ichha Dvesha Sukha Dukha Jnana Dinam Abhivyaktehe Ashraya Adhishthanam Shariram. Sharira. Adhishthana is Sharira. Adhishthana can be looked at Desha also. But here Adhishthana has a loaded meaning. It is Sharira, in which there is a Karta. Karta is Vijnanamaya Kosha. So Vijnanamaya Kosha is associated with Adhishthana. Vijnanamaya Kosha means the Atma, where there is Buddhi Sambandha. Initial, first, Ahankara Sambandha is needed. So Adhishthanam is Ichha Dvesha Sukha Dukha Jnanadinam Abhivyaktehe Ashrayaha. That is Adhishthana. Adhishthana is Ashraya. For what? For Abhivyakti, for manifestation. Of what? Of Ichha Dvesha Sukha Dukha Jnana. So it's an abode. Abode is needed. That is the Adhishthana. For any activity also you need Adhishthana. Here the Karta himself needs an Adhishthana. Not on Desha. Sharira itself is in Desha. So Sharira is needed. Therefore Adhishthanam is interpreted as Shariram. Tatha Karta. Who is this Karta? Upadhi Lakshana Bhokta also. Karta and Bhokta cannot be separated out. They are one entity. Although the Kosha Sambandha is different. Karta is in the Vijnanamaya Kosha Sambandha. And Bhokta is in the Anandamaya Kosha Sambandha. Still, they are one entity, upadhis, because Anandamaya Kosha as well as the Vijnanamaya Kosha are upadhis. Karanam cha, what is Karana? Shrotradi, Indriyas, Shabdyadi Upalabdhe, Shabda Ityadi are cognized by Shrotra Indriya Ityadi, Prathagvidam, they are various types, therefore Nana Prakaram of various types. Tat, Dwadasya Sankhyam, they are counted as 12. So here you have 5 Jnanendriyas, 5 Karmendriyas and Mana and Buddhi. So they make up 12. Vividascha Pratak Cheshtaha. What are these? Vayaviha Pranapanadhyaha. These are the 5. Various types of Kriyas which are possible only when Prana is there. Prana pushes the Indriyas towards their Vishayas and activities are possible. Pranapanadhyaha Daivam cha Eva. Daivam Eva cha. What is this daiva? Atra eteshu chaturshu panchamam panchanam puranam. All these. See, what is panchamam? Panchama vritti is tasya purane dat. So sutra, Vyakrana sutra says tasya purane dat. Dat pratyaya is added to complete the 4, and that is possible only by the 5th. So 5th will complete, make it complete. So 4 are incomplete. Adhishthana, karta, karana and cheshtas are incomplete without daiva. So daiva is the panchama, meaning it completes the 5th. It is the 5th which completes the number 5. So pancha sankhya is complete only by panchamam. Therefore, daivam cha eva, meaning daivam eva cha atra eteshu chaturshu. Among these 4, nothing can complete and make the 5th. So the 5th is this daiva. Panchamam means panchanam puranam. Completing the 5 is possible only by when the 5th comes in. That is panchamam. That 5th happens to be daiva. It adityadi chakshuradyanugrahakam. So the presiding deities, and who are these adhishtatru devatas? Adityadi. They are all manifestations of Ishvara. Thereby panchama cannot be missed. This 5th daiva is very important. These 5 are to be known, and these will lead to finally Ishvara manifest in the Sharira has to be known in various ways. Thereby it will pave the path, it will carve the path towards Jnana and thereby Moksha. Narayana Parovyakta Dandam Avyakta Sambhu Mandasyantastu Meluka Sapta Dvipacha Medini. Any questions?
I don't understand this. Pratyagatma upasarti lakshanam phalam.
What is the difficulty?
What does upasarti mean?
Upasarti is one attaining. So you can see as attaining, gachati. Upasarpi is sripdhatu is gatyarthaka dhatu. So approaching something. So approaching what here? Pratyagatma. So pratyagatma. One who, so you can understand that as having the meaning of so you can take it in multiple ways. One pratyagatma upasarpi has to be mumukshu. Or Mahamohakaram Pratyagatma Upasarpi. So it is neuter here, Upasarpi. So Mahamohakaram Pratyagatma Upasarpi. This Mahamoha, whom does it veil? What is the Mahamoha is what it is? Delusion. Who has this delusion?
Okay.
Which approaches Pratyagatma. So it is approaching the individual Jiva. So Upasarpi, it is this Mahamoha is deluding the Pratyagatma. That is the idea there. Iha. So therefore, Indrajala Maya Upam Avidya Krutam, this phala, finally whom does it approach? It approach deludes the Atma, Jivatma. So Pratyagatma Upasarpi is this Mahamoha Kara.
Oh, okay.
So Iha Phalakutaya Layam Gachati Iti Phala Nirva. So this phala is approaching. Finally, what is the phala? Phala is what I have to look, you will have to look at it. What is the Mula? Mula is phala. So phalam is explained here in the end as phalgutaya layam gachati. Between that is all the explanation of phala. What is phala? Bahya aneka karaka vyapar nishpannam sat. That is phala. It is avidya krita. Actually it is karma, karma krita. Karma is avidya krita. And indrajala maya upamam avidya kritam. All this is attained by everything that is avidya karya. So phala has to be avidya karya, karma itself is avidya karya. Phala is karma nishpanna. And what is this avidya itself? Avidya is indrajala maya upama. Therefore, mahamoha karam, this phala will create impressions and then will make a person be under the pressure of vasanas to act out. Therefore, kama and karma. So phala itself sows the seeds for more and more karma. So mahamoha karam and pratyagatma upasarpi mahamoha karam. So this phala will approach the pratyagatma itself, because phala cannot go waste. Unless there is jnana, phala will not not
it has to
let the jiva alone. So it will force the jiva to become bhokta. Therefore this karta pratyagatma upasarpi mahamoha karam phalam iha phalgutaya, then that is explained as phalgutaya layam gachati. Okay.
Okay. And so this panchama karanani pancha imani karanani, is this like a prakriya here, like Bhagavan is explaining?
Not a prakriya, it's a fact in every karya. Can you do anything without the grace of indriyas?
No, I
indriyas are there. Indriya golaka is there, there indriyas are there. But without the indriyas functioning, can we do anything? No. So why are the indriyas functioning? Let the science aside. Even sometimes scientists can't make out as to why is something working the way it is working. They can't explain it all. It is all technical. To the extent that this is happening, why cannot be answered? So Vedanta says that you can see because Aditya Devata is blessing the Indriyas. If the eyes are weak, you pray to Surya, Aditya, and then you see that is a Vaidika Prakriya. So Alaukika Upaya. And when you start seeing that Ishvara manifests as Adhishtatra Devata, then you are bringing Ishvara more and more into your own presence. So there is no scope for the jiva to claim an individuality. As soon as everything is blessed by Ishvara, that daiva makes or breaks. Ishvara manifests as devatas, indriya devatas, starts blessing everything. Thereby, what is it that you have achieved? If you look at it, every person who claims, I have achieved this, what have you achieved? jnana is possible only in buddhi. Buddhi can be sharpened, but sharpened in the sense you cannot gain a particular type of buddhi. You came with a particular type of buddhi.
Mm-hmm.
The strength given is your own strength, but how did it come about? No, it is my strength. I am a self-made man, self-made woman. These terms are with ahankara, that I have this. I have good looks. That beauty is blessed by Ishvara. I was born with that beauty. I didn't earn it in this life by, you know, saying that I made it. I didn't make it. The strength that is given, whether it is physical or emotional, I am strong. Can I really claim it? The strength is given. Buddhi, I am an intellectual. Can I claim it? It is given. So what is it that you have done then? I have just claimed it, nothing else. So if you look at it, everything is blessed by Daiva. That's why Daiva is also a word which is interpreted as fate. Manifest as Prarabdha. Of course, I earned it in earlier Janma. But that also was with blessings. As we saw last time, why should I gain any phala by offering whatever belongs to Ishvara? Why should I get any phala? But I do get it. That is the vyavastha. There is nothing that I have done. I am taking something from what is already offered, using the tools which are already given, and then bring out something, some karma out of these, which was already given, and then claim the phala. So it's a setup of actually contributing nothing. The jiva is contributing nothing really. But still there is a phala associated. And that is said here as daiva. So daiva, it is not a prakriya. Seeing Ishvara as the inherent principle in everything. It's a prakriya, in the sense it is a prakriya that is there through and through Vedanta. Ishavasyam idam sarvam. So you start seeing Ishvara everywhere. Anyway, daiva, we'll see more in the next this thing. So there, then these, each of these are discussed there. We'll see more of that. Okay.
No, when I asked if it's a prakriya, I thought it is like a neti neti prakriya or something like that.
No, no, it is not. I mean, all of this is explained in as daiva, but daiva is Ishwariya. So it's devata, devata sambandhi. So, and here we see that particularly mentioned as what? Panchama is chakshurad janugrahakam. And then we see what is anugraha is possible only by Ishvara. So Ishvara manifests as Adhishtatru Devatas. So it's a way to analyze. Another way to, if you look at Prakriya, then it is another way to analyze as to the limitations of all that Karaka Bheda without the Daiva.
Yeah.
Leading to the underlying principle as to what is the Tattva behind. Because all these five have to be seen, and these will be seen further in 15th onwards. We'll see more of this. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. That's it.
Okay. Thank you.